All right, so I'm gonna try and I don't know, embrace this day a little. There's a pit bull in the house. I'm kind of not having a receptive action with it. I'm like, well, I go downstairs and the dog is shying away from me, you know, running away. And so because the dog is running away from me, what's going on? I'm getting a little frightened out, like it's about to be an agitator of attack, provoke, quick, you know. And so I'm like, well, okay, I'll go outside with the dog for a moment, you know, just go outside, and then there, well, you know, I'll throw out, you know, some old broken biscuit cookie, not a cookie sweet, but, you know, an old broken piece of something, because there's no dog cookies here. And no, there's just a shying from the cookie itself. And so we're in a severe anxiety disorder with this dog. Severe. I cannot be around children at all, ever. Ever. It's a very bad deal. So I can't take the dog on a walk. It's a male. Can't take him on a walk. Yeah. We're talking, has the dog been beaten, hit? My any kind of hand reach out is immediate, like, you know, I'm totally scared of you. Totally scared of you. And I'm like, well, is it my teeth? You know, because they say, you know, those dogs, you know, they look at your teeth. You know, any kind of, you know, woof action. So I'm like, well, maybe that's it. Maybe I have the sneer of, rawr, you know, maybe that's my teeth. It could be my teeth. So what are we gonna do about pit bulls? And I know everybody's saying, but it's only 40%. The dog is only 40%. And I'm like, well, that's it. I don't care. It's acting pit bull. It looks pit bull with that extra head action. You know, the hard head. I mean, it's just, I'm not really sure how you all are gonna deal with a dog like this. It's just next to impossible. It just becomes a rule of your life. You know, it has to be cared for by certain people. People that are so like, yeah, okay, it's not a big deal, it's not a big problem, you know. Yeah, you can't take the dog on a walk. I mean, at what point is that just taking over your life? And why? Why do you want a dog that you can't take on a walk? That's another thing, you know. So maybe she's scared for me of that, because I'm already, you know, it's a he. So I'm like, okay, well, I'll change the name. It's Handsome. I'll change the name to something, Gabloo or something. If I change it to Gabloo, you know, maybe that'll you know, soften it out, you know, because it's a sad dog. It's a sad dog. It's creeping away from me. Yeah. Hurriedly running, you know, 20 feet away, like immediately, on sight, you know, at our first meeting. You know, this severe, it's a severe disabled dog, you know, it's just not healthy. So, yeah, I mean, I guess I don't have an answer. Fatten it with dog cookies? Perhaps this is serious. This is a serious situation. When the dog is like that, it's actually snapped back at me pretty quickly. You know, just if I enter the room and it is not aware at that moment. You know, there has been a situation where, what was it? It was that old English sheepdog that was the movie dog of Hollywood, attacked its owner. You know, had been there like for 11 years and all. And so it like ruined the, you know, the names of old English sheepdogs everywhere as being, you know, the nice, cuddly, smuggly play dogs. Now all of a sudden they're just gonna kill their owners. yeah. So when all of this is going on, I'm not really sure what to do, because it's just like a scare provision that's now been delivered into the house. You know, it's just a scare. The dog itself is bringing scare in. it's a trembly, it's a trembly deal. It's a trembly deal, isn't it? You know, and I'm so playful with dogs. I'm so playful with dogs, but I I'm trying the high pitches, and normally that works. You know, snaps them out of their, and I'm so tough and rough. No, it's just she's not jumping out of that, or he's not jumping out. I mean, has it been fixed? I mean, look, I need some query here. I mean, has the dog been fixed? Has to have been fixed. This. I hope those are not legitimate. Yeah. Oh my gosh. I mean, what kind of neighborhood do you live in? I mean, all these things are running up and through my mind. You know, this is a dog sitting situation. I mean, and you live with this dog. I mean, where do you live? Do you live in like Beirut? I'm just kind of angry. I'm just kind of angry that. That this is going on, that a dog like that is apparently this old and from puppydom, had from a puppy. I mean, this is a serious situation. This is a dog that's been kept as from a puppy. You know what I mean? So if the dog's been kept as from a puppy and it's acting like this, what was the deal? You follow the crate training, had a little too long maybe in that crate. Yeah, I'm absolutely opposed to crate training. I don't go for that at all. Somebody has to be with that little puppy, just like Mama-san, you know, just like Mama-san on the raise. I mean, I don't get this. Why would you ever put a dog in a crate? Ever. It takes 3 days to potty train any puppy. 3 days. So I'm like, what's the deal? So it looks like he's been kept in a crate too long, and I really don't care who you are, that was idiocy. Because now the dog is, just bonkers, absolutely bonkers. Gosh dang it. Yeah, I mean, and is there some food? Is there like a passivator food? I mean, there's catnip for the cats. Is there something for the dogs? It used to be just give them the Milk-Bone dog biscuits or something, but now these breeds are so freaking upsetive. And I'm going back to Schnoo, because Schnoo was a pretty much a hideaway dog. You know, he would hide in the corners and things, and you know. But this one is like really selective in who it trusts, and he only seems to trust, you know, this woman, or only seems to trust that woman. So I mean, this could even be a color of hair issue. It could be that extreme. So this is not a borstal situation. This is not normal. We're dealing with a mentally ill dog. What kind of food? Is there some kind of food? I would immediately switch it to a vegetarian diet. They have vegetarian dog foods out there. Absolutely, immediately switch it to vegetarian. Yeah, handsome. That is a bad name also. Because it is a name that is not callable. It's a name that is not really used. It's not fun. So gablu gablu gosno sno. You know, come on. Jeez, be nice to your dog. Can't believe in a crate and then you give him a name of handsome. How much do you hate the male race, you know? That's what it starts to look like.